everyone, welcome to another episode of Carography with Joey Logano. I got my 1930 Ford sedan rat rod here, but I want to do it a little different this time. I want to take you to my buddy's house, who also likes a little patina, also likes things slammed on the ground. They happen to be Volkswagens. We won't judge them on that part, but let's go. We are here today at Daniel Soares' house. He's a big Volkswagen guy. He's got some really cool cars. We have a lot of fun talking to each other at the racetrack about his collection and my collection. So I thought, why not? Let's bring him on the show and see what he's got.
What's up, amigo?
What's happening?
How are you?
I'm good. How you been?
Everything good, man.
I've never seen the whole collection in person. I've seen one here, one there.
This is my girl. These are my boys. And she's actually my dream girl. You know, it's funny because every guy, you know, we have a dream car, right?
Yes.
And very often my friends, you know, exotic cars, very expensive cars. Since I can remember, this has been my dream car. Like a Boss 23 window. I'm a big patina guy. You know, I like, original them. Stuff. And this Boss actually has original paint. You know, it's actually
paint.
Pretty nice.
Yeah.
But it's original paint. Everything is original, never been repainted. Right. Got it from Pennsylvania. It was the last 10 years, Pennsylvania.
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 In American,
right?
That's Pennsylvania.
Hey, I bet your Mexican fans, they got that. No, this thing has 36 horsepower. Like, top speed is 50 miles per hour.
I followed you to the racetrack one time in this.
Do you remember?
Your doors off.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. This thing, you cannot be in a rush. Guys, you cannot be in a rush.
But you can bring a lot of friends.
Oh, man, you can bring the whole party. You go everywhere and people want to take pictures, but cannot be in a rush. I don't drive it much. I drive it probably once every month or two. The one that actually I drive every single week is this guy.
This is your everyday cruiser.
This is my everyday cruise. And the reason why I like this one a lot.
You can't scratch the paint.
You cannot scratch the paint. So if somebody hits you a little bit, doesn't really matter. This car I got in California like 5 years ago. I brought it here. I bought the wheels. I started buying all the parts. Yep. When I got a bunch of them, I sent it to Mexico. And then we did the restoration because no paint, just the chassis. Yep. This one actually can go 80, 90 miles per hour at 3,000 RPM, and it's cruising. The engine has 170 horsepower. It has a big engine. Sunroof, it's a European, which, have you ever seen these things work?
No.
Look at this. Watch out over there.
Oh, whoa, no way. Look at that.
Look at this side.
That's cool.
Let me tell you something that is very funny. I use this car a lot, and every time that I use the turn signals, I use those things, but people don't know.
People don't know what that means.
So I'm with my hand like.
You know, my son, Hudson, you know Hudson.
Yeah.
He is in love with Herbie the Love Bug. We watch Herbie all the time. I'm sure you've seen Herbie,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
I thought I'd see his Halloween costume though. I made a whole, he wanted to be Herbie for Halloween. So I don't think you have that bug here.
Let me tell you, man. I think Hudson and I in 10 years we're
going to be best buddies. You guys are really, really tight. Yes. Yeah.
I want to tell you something about this car. This car, we call him a Raton. Raton is mouse in Spanish. So because the color and the headlights are yellow.
No, it's like a mouse. I see
exactly,
what you're saying.
Exactly. Okay. I told you before that my dad sold his business to support me, right, in my career.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
That was probably like 10 years ago, 10 to 12 years ago. Like 5 years ago, I went to him and I said, hey, Dad, what about if we restore a car and slowly we start the shop again? He said, man, I don't know. You know, finally, after like 6 months, I convinced him about doing it.
Yeah.
And we have always had cars, right? And this car, my dad actually was trying to sell it for like 2 years. And nobody wanted it. It was ugly. But it was in very good shape. You know, one of those ugly cars, but actually they're solid, but they're just not good looking.
Yeah.
So this car, nobody wanted it. And my dad told me, you know what? That car that nobody wanted it is a perfect car to make as the first car of the shop and then try to make like a exactly.
Yeah.
So they see the before and after. So the car was ugly. So when we start working on it, we paint it, we start putting the car together, everyone wanted to buy it. And now I say, no,
I'm staying here. That car.
I'm staying here. Yeah, but I didn't tell you, but this car was actually in the Cars 3 movie.
In Cars 3?
Yeah. It wasn't like a character, but it was as a third person there.
I saw the picture up here.
Yeah.
And I thought, oh man, I forgot you're in Cars and you had the whole thing like...
That's pretty cool. Like, that's the coolest.
Yeah, that's super cool. You have to show me your car, too.
I'll see what I got. Okay, all right. So
show me what you got.
This is my, some might call it a death trap. 1930 Ford sedan, rat rod. I thought that made sense to bring over here because I know you like the patina stuff. So it's like a gunslinger kind of theme behind it, right?
Okay,
so
yeah.
So he's got, you know, shotgun shells all over the thing. So like the door, that's the door hinge. You can't open the door, so it's on the ground right now. For me, this is my problem. I'm kind of tall. You're pretty tall too. And when you sit in it, your eye line's right here, right into the dash.
So you either go down or you high, right?
You gotta go down. You gotta go down through the steering wheel and kind of to the left of the engine. And it's either that or you pop up. And you go above, but you're kind of eating some bugs at that point.
All right, and you have a trailer connection there?
Yeah, you know, you pull stuff around. Pull your bug around.
Yeah. Man, we have to go for a ride.
Let's go, nice day, eh?
Thank you.